this is our entrance downstairs. Ceiling here in our hallway, and in order to do that, I have to take down the roof, and I can go outside and show how that works. But looking here from the insides, the job that I'm about to do is about this. We have. I can maybe stand away. So it's this one here is the old outer exterior wall, and at some point it was extended with this room over here, with the staircase down to the cellar, and I'm going to take down this roof in order to be able to take down all of this wall here. And then also take down the wall, the ceiling here. And yeah, it's just, it's pretty straightforward, I think. It's going out on the scaffolding, see how much I can take down from the top, and then make a hole in the ceiling somewhere, and begin to just tear everything out. Putting it in a pile and take it to the junkyard. So that is the task I will begin with today. I don't know if I'm able to complete, but things always take a little more time than what I anticipate. That's at least my learning so far. So I will do that now. This is the space above the ceiling that I just showed you downstairs, and the plan is here to take down these the old roof structure here, which is it doesn't support anything anymore. It's it has been replaced by this new structure that you see up here with the new insulation and all that, and this is just hard work in a cramped space. And this is just something that I need to do and get over with. And then we can begin to pick the old roof down, and then at some point I will begin to take down the ceiling from the inside, because this is kind of like, or at least I consider it to be like sawing the branch you are sitting on, and that is from a safety point of view, it's not the wisest thing I'm doing here, but I'm safe so far. But I don't plan to take everything down from the top while standing on it or sitting on it, so that is what I'm going to do now, and then we'll see where that takes us. So now I cut a hole in the ceiling or roof, and let's check out how it looks. You can see here, and I'm sorry for the lighting. Made a cut here, made a cut there, so. These can just be taken out. Like this. Then there's a set of boards again. But these are then mounted to the ceiling downstairs. But I could do the same. Just so it's wired up. This is going to get messy or dusty at least. This is our entrance downstairs. So now there's only one way, and that is forward. I'll try to board something up from the outside here, so we again can prevent no uninvited guests. So now I've made a hole. I know where I can begin. On the inside of the entrance, and now I'll do the other side, the thing that was added to the house afterwards. I just talked about downstairs, and I will I'll just do that now. So let's. Let's get going on that. Okay, again, I will try to cut the ceiling from the top. Because I think that will ease my task when I go inside, because yeah, it's by that staircase, and I don't really have a good place to stand down there. So I think I'll, as much as I can do from the upside, eller top side, I will try to do. So let me see if I can do that now. That's the plan. Okay, so I'm not that comfortable with just sawing this up. I'm trying to, for each cut, I'm staying on the left side of the beam holding the roof, and I'm sitting on that part, and it should all logic says it should work. But yeah, I'm not super comfortable with cutting away that, I must say. So what should I do? Maybe I can reach in and cut I'll do it in bigger pieces, and then I can sit out there where I know it's supported, because that's where I have those things to hold
Yeah, to hold the roof from the from the inside or below. So if I sit here and cut here, then it should work. Okay, so that worked. That worked okay, I would say. Now I'll cut again one side and take it out. Not stand on it, but just stand on the scaffolding and make sure that we can be safe while we do it.